snow. It looks like drugs, but it isn't drugs. It's nature's unflavored icy, and it falls from the sky uncontrollably, but you can control it with visual effects, which is what we're doing today. We're sipping from the tasty slushy of After Effects. We're compositing snow. A few months ago, we looked at how to composite rain, and snow can actually be even easier than rain depending on your scene. For example, something like this is very simple. Just add in some snow stock footage to your comp, which there are plenty of great places to get solid assets like from Adobe Stock or Action VFX. And often you'll find these types of assets on a black background. But unlike rain, we're gonna be using After Effects' Unmult preset to key this out. You generally don't wanna use blending modes here since snow is opaque. That's why snow falling in front of a bright sky can actually look darker. So instead, select a tint effect and select a color from the footage to match the snow to the environment, giving us this. It's a very quick way to help integrate into the shot, matching the lighting or color tone of the screen, such as these warmer lit environments, for example. Some shots also benefit from changing the color temperature to push it to a visually colder tone and lifting the shadows for a flatter look. And like we showed with rain, we can go through similar steps when needing to push the shot all the way there, like using the rotobrush tool, which we'll use to cut out foreground elements to separate them. And if we have a moving camera, we'll track that as well and build up layers of snow stock for the background and foreground as needed. And we'll also use a blur effect like this here when we need to match depth of field. You'll also want your snow to show up stronger around light sources like we see in these real world examples, which I have said before, when you can get them, references are massively helpful with any compositing work. Having something as a guide to help you find that realism is key to arriving at the final result you are aiming for. But getting that stronger look around light sources can be done with a similar method as we did with rain, by either using an adjustment layer with a fast box blur effect boosted high and a curves effect to make it brighter. Then we'll choose the snow as an alpha matte layer so we only see the blur within the snow. The benefit of this is it works with the color, bright, and dark areas of the scene, which could vary a lot. But sometimes instead, you can just use a duplicate of the tinted snow method with a feathered mask drawn around the light sources, then brighten and recolor the tint effect to match that source. And while it works best if there is already snow laying on the ground during the actual shoot, you can use some techniques to brighten and recolor sections. We did this by using an adjustment layer with a tint effect to desaturate and a curves effect to lift the brightness. Then with a duplicate of the footage, we'll use another curves to crush the contrast, then set the adjustment layer to use the duplicated footage as a lumen matte, and we can fine tune the settings to control how much or little snow we want on the surface. Lastly, we'll draw a mask to keep the ground section and feather. Then to complete this, we'll change the color to a colder blue tone with lifted shadows and add in snow stock, unmulting the black background and tinting to match our environment. You can also try using Adobe Photoshop's Gen Fill tool to add more realistic snow in areas of your shot. In this example, we drew around different sections using the lasso tool and asked Gen Fill to add snow, choosing the best options for each area, then importing that back into After Effects, where we'll mask away the top section for the footage to be fully visible beneath. Then we'll go through the same color and snow stock steps as before to get this. And like with rain, again, the best version of this effect will be combined with some in-camera effects as well. Having potato flakes or something similar dropping on your talent so you can have that physical interaction will go miles in fully selling the effect. But if you're handed footage without that, you can still get some pretty convincing looks like we've shown here. But that's it for today. If you have something that you would like to see us cover in the future, post that in the comments below. And don't forget to like and subscribe because armadillo shells are bulletproof. Now you know.